This slide is actually a little bit old. We're over 4,500 members at this point in time right now. Current tribe members who are here, can you guys just raise your hands so that they know who you are? These are people who have come out, along with the group that we have at the RV outside, and who can be a testament, really, to what the tribe is about and the fact that we have people everywhere.
How did it feel being on the Texas leg?
Badass. Everything is bigger in Texas, including the rush. It was a good time. Had a lot of fun. Nice to meet some young people who are eager to travel. Lots of people who will be hopping into the tribe real soon, and looking forward to seeing them there.
What first day going to be on? Going from Texas to Arizona, Arizona to Vegas, Vegas to Cali. West side.
How do you feel?
I feel good. I feel excited. Ready to have some fun, laugh, cook, just have a good time.
Today is the last day of the college presentations for the RV college tour, and it's been insane to sit back and actually have a moment and think about all that's been put into this project and all the schools that we've been to and everything that has just gone into it, from raising the money and doing everything with Kickstarter to getting the people together to going from city to city to staying at people's houses, and each and every person and student that we touched, faculty member that we touched, it's just been an absolute amazing ride, and I'm finally getting a chance to kind of be and center myself around the fact that this has actually happened and happening and riding out through Texas. So tears have already been shed. I know there's gonna be a lot more as this hits me, but it's been an amazing ride, and we just gotta get to LA.
Fairfield Inn and Suites, Fort Worth, Texas.
Nomad.
They got some that are right off
Nomad.
Of the highway.
Nomad.
After finishing up in Houston, it was all about getting through the ride through the rest of Texas. We knew we had to split it up, so we decided to spend the night in Fort Worth. And ironically, the next morning we woke up with a free day and decided that we were gonna take it and drive to Roswell, New Mexico. Definitely an eclectic bunch, not surprised that we came up with the idea of going through UFO town, and we had to get to Los Angeles some way, so why not?
At the entire Atlas of maps. That's Nomadness, chaps.
Formerly, sure they got a pool.
It has a pool, but the closest one to what, like, to the UFO museum?
Days in Roswell.
Oh.
We out here in alien land, Roswell, New Mexico.
It's amazing to find a town that's like legitimately a gimmick and they embrace it. Everywhere you go, the Denny's has signs that say aliens welcome here. Like, they run with this. I mean, gotta respect them for it.
But then on the other
hand, then they turn to look at us like we're crazy.
Is it a gimmick? You know what I mean?
Hey. You know what? We are stupid to think that we are the only ones out here.
True that?
I'm sorry. They told me in school there's 9 planets. Minus that, they vetoed one, made it back a star. Pluto, shout out to you. No, they vetoed one. But you think out of all 9 of them, or 8 plus a star, that we the only ones? Give me a goddamn break.
Gotta look at
I'm
it.
With this dude right here.
Yeah.
So what's the deal with Roswell? What's the deal?
Actually, Roswell is only famous because we had the nearest airbase at the time.
Okay.
There was a crash back here back in 1947. A gentleman by the name of Mark Brazel came on this, or he actually worked on this ranch. He went out there to go do his work and noticed that the animals were detouring away from an
what
area.
What did we say about animal sensory? Mm-hmm. We've been saying this we've been talking about pets and animals and how they pick up on stuff. Mm-hmm.
So he went out there to go see what it was, and the crash site was 3/4 wide and 3 football fields long.
Oh.
He took a bunch of the metal. Mm-hmm. He came into town, which was about 70-something miles. Mm-hmm. And the sheriff's department called the base that was here at the time. The base came out there and they looked at it. They sent 2 guys out there, and then that's when the conspiracy and everything. And then that's kind of where it went kind of he said, she said stuff.
Okay.
The rancher was questioned for about 3-4 days on his story. Mm-hmm. He was told to change the story or his family would be killed. They went through his house and everybody's houses that are out there. And they pulled up the floorboards, they went through drawers, they went through everything and threatened to kill Mac Brazel died years later, and even on his deathbed, he refused to stay quiet.
So we were given secret packets when we came in here, and we don't know what's in them.
Information from the era of time. The timeline of the Roswell incident, which is very helpful.
From July 4th. Oh, Independence Day, 1947. Okay. Aha. Who became independent?
Yeah. They were trying to come down here and get free.
Yeah.
Give us free.
Yeah, the real war was against.
This is the second largest research center. The other one is the Vatican, as the gentleman outside.
The Vatican. I just had to say that with some own.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Church.
These are like squadrons, Air Force bombers.
To be perfectly,
like, there's nothing.
Yeah, but the report.
The Tuskegee Airmen ever see something?
I mean,
I don't know. That's a good question, actually. That'd be something to research.
When you look at the old carvings from each culture, you'll see that certain things just look
similar.
Look like alien-like shapes.
And even to, probably those ancient civilizations, the Mayans, the Aztecs, the Egyptians, to a certain degree, I think they were so much smarter and more advanced than what we are presently.
Yeah, right.
They were probably more interesting to deal with. Now they're like, you come to Earth, they're going to try and blow you up.
Right.
You might get caught in a crossfire, them blowing themselves up.
Dude, you see something? That's why I travel for World Wonders. I travel based around world wonders and ruins like Cambodia, Angkor Wat, seeing Taj Mahal. Like,
because it's the truth.
These are things that blow your mind. Even with modern technology, it's like
there's
no way that you would be able to do this.
Con los terroristas. They do the Harlem Shake.